Do you want to remember everything that you read? Did you ever realize how much information that we forget every single day? Even the things that we spend hours and hours studying. But then you see some extraordinary people like this.
She's memorized the entire book.
We'll see.
Page 38.
Starts mid-sentence. Information effectively by using humor. Are you gifted with numbers?
Now what if I tell you that you can do that too? That too in just 1 week from now.
So Tharun, you have 20 seconds to remember these 15 words. These 15 words.
Okay.
Ready?
Ready.
Sounds interesting. Hello everyone, welcome back to one of the most awaited videos on the channel. And if you're new here, my name is Tharun and I'm a recent graduate from IIT Kharagpur. See, I've been preparing for some or the other kind of exams for the past 12 years, and during the process, I read books after book, did courses after courses, and spent so many hours researching about the best ways to learn things faster. And a few years back, I came across something called as the photographic memory. And it actually blew my mind. I mean, how can people just look at something and just remember it as it is? So I started researching about it more and more, and this video is going to be the entire guide about how our brain actually works, why do you even remember things, the truth about photographic memory, and three best memory techniques so that you can be pro at remembering things. But before we go there, you first need to slow down and understand how our brain actually works. So research shows that our brains have been evolved to remember the information, which actually helps in our survival and also help us fit in better in the environment. So basically, our brain only remembers things if it truly believes that something is actually important for our life at that point of time. So what can you learn from this? A simple weird answer would be making your brain feel that whatever you want to remember as important. But how do we hack our brain to do that? Obviously, our brain wouldn't care about some random organic chemistry reaction, because at that point of time, it in no way will help us in our survival. But at the same time, your brain would actually remember why your teacher has scolded you, because there's an emotion attached over there. So basically, our brain has some emotion bias. So the stronger the emotion is, the better our brain remembers it. Like something should be useful, something should have some immediate value addition into our life so that our brain actually feels that this is important to remember it. Now once our brain actually understands that something is important and tries to remember it, it will be easier for the neurons to connect the new information onto the existing information. And that's where relation comes in. Our brains are really good at remembering things that we can actually relate to. Now, once some information actually gets into the brain through the first principle, value, and the new information attaches to the existing information to the second principle, which is relation, all this information that we have collected strengthens only through repetition. So the conclusion is this: our brain actually remembers the information through value, relation, and then repetition. So now as you understood the basic principles of how our memory actually works, let's answer one of the biggest questions, which is the truth about the photographic memory. Does photographic memory even exist? Do people actually have powers to look at something and just remember it as it is? The answer is no. People don't have powers like photographic memory, just like how magicians don't have magical powers. But there are tricks, memory tricks or memory techniques, which if you can master, you can be the magician of your own memory. You can actually surprise everyone in the room. And in the next 2 minutes, we are going to discuss about three of these things, which if you can master, you can be a pro at remembering things. And I myself have actually tested all of these three things again during the past 1 week, just to see if it actually works or not. And I need to be honest, if you can actually master these three things, you'll never forget anything which you want in your entire life again. Let's get started. The first method is derived from the first principle that we discussed, value. The theory of active recall is a method which actually signals your mind that the information that you're learning is so much valuable for you. Active recall means to force your brain to retrieve information from it. Simply from the next time whenever you're trying to read something or learn something, just take a break, just come back to the same thing and try to recall the entire information without actually looking into your notes. Basically, instead of making the short notes, make questions and write them on the front side of the paper and write answers to it on the back side of the paper. Now force your brain to answer the question that you made, and this will trick your brain to make you feel that the information that is provided is actually important and you'll remember it forever. Now the second method is derived from the second principle, relation. Memory castle is the idea of relating whatever you are learning, the new information, to the existing knowledge, the old information. Simply, it's just connecting dots of whatever you actually know and whatever that you're learning new. This technique is also called as the memory palace, in which you mentally visualize a familiar location, maybe your own house or your own room or maybe a castle. And then you try to associate some specific information or a list of items on different rooms and different locations of that room or that house or that castle. And that's a great method to remember things. Like, just try it out once. Try to visualize your own room, put a list of things on different walls, different locations, and then you try to just try to retrieve the information back, and you'll remember it in a much better way. And now, the final and one of the most important methods is the Sirianni method. This method is derived from the third principle, repetition. And this method in a way actually helps you how to build flashcards in a much effective manner. So basically there are three things which make a flashcard very effective: summary, relation, and representation. Step one, give the flashcard a title, write a summary of the concept that you have learned, write it informally. It should not sound like your own textbook. Step two, write about the relation that you made with an existing concept. Explain how this current knowledge is associated with the existing knowledge that you already had. Step three, draw a picture to represent the concept visually. Or simply draw the first image which pops up into your mind when you are actually learning the concept. And from the next time, whenever you sit in front of your desk or before you go to sleep, look at your flashcards that you have made. And trust me, you'll never actually forget any information that you have written in this method. See, I've tried out this method and it actually works wonders. Because the repetition signals our brain to move this information which is present in the short-term memory into the long-term memory. So finally, these are the three methods, and this was me trying to use the memory castle method to remember a list of 10 things. Watch it.
Oh, 17 seconds, man. Nice.
So basically, I have attached story and emotion over here. So first things first, we have our apple. So apple, then pin like a pierce kar diya. How much it has went inside. So uske liye scale chahiye. Scale, I have to say it in a book. So book. Okay, I have to take it. So I need a pen. So pen is not with me, pen is with Neeraj. So Neeraj har din jaake ball smash karta hai. Ball smash, power. Power, which means quantum. I did not post video since last 30 days. So emergency matlab water peena hai, to glass. Where am I drinking it? I'm drinking it at Hyderabad mein Nawab se fossil. I need peace right now, to kinder. And now it's your time to try these out. See, if you can actually practice these methods for a period of time, and if you can master these techniques, you can actually remember hundreds of words in a row by just looking at it for a minute. And that's how powerful these methods are. But all these methods are just a tip of the iceberg. There are more better scientific methods that you can adopt, especially if you're a JEE aspirant right now. So to help every student who's struggling with their studies, I'm going to launch my own mentorship program very soon. I'll make separate video about it later. But for now, if you're a student who also follows my main channel, you already know that I've launched my Not Just a Video Editing course, where we are teaching video editing, design, YouTube, freelancing, and how to build your own agency. All of this in just 2 to 3 months of time. And just as a token of gratitude for this channel members, you can go to tarunspeaks.in right now and use the code Quantum Project to get extra discounts for all of you for the next 3 days. Got it? I'll see you on the website. Bye-bye.